Welcome students. Here we are discussing about the structure of the atom, and in previous class we have also discussed about the some model that represent the atom, and we seen that the J.J. Thomson model of that atom, and also we see looked at the experiment, the scattering of the alpha particle by a gold foil, which is sent by the Rutherford, and we have discussed that also, and we have concluded that experiment with some postulates, that is there is a positively charged charged center in an atom called the nucleus. Nearly all the mass of an atom resides in the nucleus. So Rutherford at last concluded the some postulates. So by the experimental results he concluded that next they saying that the positively charged particles that present at the center and which having the all mass. Next he said that the electrons revolve around the nucleus in the circular path. So he also said that these electrons are revolve around this and we call it as the nucleus. So these electrons are surround this that is nucleus in the circular path. Next he said that the size of the nucleus is very small as compared to the size of the atom. So he also said that the size of the this nucleus is very small as compared to the atom. So we have already said that the atom will also we cannot see. So the imagination is that nucleus is too small than that of the atom. So we concluded in the reasons why the atom like this. So atom is like this. He showed that, but although there is some drawbacks of the Rutherford model of an atom, let's read about the revolution of the electron in a circular orbit is not expected to be a stable. So he let revolution of electron is so circular path ಒಳಗೆ revolve ಆಗತೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಯಾವುದು ನಮಗೆ proof ಇಲ್ಲ ಯಾವುದು ತಿಳಿಯ ಅಂತ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ ರಿವಾಲ್ವ್ ಆಗ್ತೈತೆ ಅನ್ನಕ್ಕೆ ಏನ್ ಗ್ಯಾರಂಟಿ ಐತಿ? ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಲೂಸಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಸೊ ಯಾವುದೇ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ಲಿ ರಿವಾಲ್ವ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಲೂಸಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಫಾಲ್ ಇನ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದಿ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಸಾರಿ ದಿಸ್ ಆಟಮ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಟಮ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಸೈಮಲ್ಟೇನಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ದ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್. ಸೊ ಇದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಏನಾಗೈತಿ ರೋದರ್ಫೋರ್ಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ ಕೊಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಎನಿ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಟ್ ವುಡ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಗೋ ಎಕ್ಸಲರೇಷನ್. ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸಲರೇಷನ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ವುಡ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಟ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಸೊ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗಬೇಕಾದಂತ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ದೇ ರೇಡಿಯೇಟ್ ದಿ ಸಮ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದಸ್ ದಿ ರಿವಾಲ್ವಿಂಗ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಲೂಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ and finally fall into that nucleus. Finally it will fall into that nucleus. If this were so, the atom should be highly unstable. Hangaagidare matte atom unstable aagutte. Hence the matter would not exist in the form that we know. We all know that atoms are quite stable. So adre ik na nodu atoms ennavu quite stable. So this fails the Rutherford's model. Next comes that is Bohr's model of an atom. Next comes that Bohr's University. he got the Nobel Prize for his work. So when he wrote the structure of atom, he got the Nobel Prize of the, this atomic structure. Among the professors, both numerous writings, three appearing books are. He also writes the books about this, the theory of spectra and atomic constitution, atomic theory, and the description of the nature. So he also wrote some books regarding the atomic theory only. So in order to overcome the objections raised against the Rutherford model of an atom, Niels Bohr put forward the following postulates about the model of an atom. After Rutherford, he also did experiment that the how is the structure of the atom, and he also put forth the some postulates. Only certain special orbits known as the discrete orbits of the electrons are allowed to inside the atom. The second one is, while revolving in discrete orbits, the electrons do not radiate energy. So he said that only a certain special orbits known as the discrete orbit of the electron. He said that there is no one orbit. He put forth the another term, that is orbit, because all the electrons are not revolving with this nucleus, but there is some discrete orbit. So this one is the orbit and another one is the orbit. So there are several orbits are there which electrons revolves around the nucleus, and by revolving the revolving in discrete orbits, the electrons do not radiate energy. So in revolve aagbe kanthanga adu energy ne inagiri radiate aagi maarudilla antare yaar heltara Niels Bohr heltara. Next, these orbits or shells are called as energy levels. So these orbits, these type of orbits are being called as the shells. That is, these energy are orbits are energy level, shells are called as the energy levels. These are also called as the energy levels. So next, the energy levels in an atom are shown in the figure. So he named it the term as, first this one is the nucleus, and another shell is, that is K shell, and another shell, that is L shell, and another which is a M, and last one N shell. So we are having they indicate the number also, and which is L equal to 1, and which is L is N equal to 2, and it is N equal to 3, and N, that is N equal to 4. Rutherford said that just the nucleus and electron is revolving around the nucleus, but Niels Bohr tells that that nucleus is also present, that was correct, but electrons are revolving in the discrete energy levels. So there is a different types of energy levels are there. So in that reason, that electron will revolving, and while they revolving, they do not radiate the energy. So these postulates are given by the Bohr's model of an atom. Next, he showed that the first shell, that is energy level, which is a K shell, and next shell, that is a L shell, and next M. There is a N number of the shells. Next O, P, Q. So these are the continuous process that he also noted as N equal to 1, N equal to 2, and N equal to 3, and N equal to 4. Next, this is about the Bohr's model of an atom. Next, there is a question are there. That is, on the basis of the Thomson's model of an atom, explain how the atom is neutral as a whole. So you should explain that the watermelon model or Christmas pudding model, and you should explain that. Now, next question is, on the basis of the Rutherford's model of an atom, which subatomic particle is present in the nucleus of an atom? go through that and you answer that questions. If you have any doubt, please contact me or message me. Next, draw a sketch of Bohr's model of an atom with the three shells. So three shells means that is K, L, M. Three shells, and you should draw like this. Next, what do you think would be the observation of alpha particle scattering experiment is carried out using a foil of a metal other than gold? So he selected that the gold foil because it is a very thin foil. If he selected the another foil, and it will he will also conduct that experiment with other also, but there is a no experiment results, that much of experimental results we cannot observe in that other than gold metal. So he selected that the gold metal. Next one is neutrons.
Electrons in the revolve of the discrete energy shells.
subatomic particles. Next, helium atom has an atomic mass of 4u and 2 protons, and in its nucleus, how many neutrons does have? So we have already said that the protons and neutrons to give the mass number. So here mass of the helium is 4 and here protons are 2. So the neutrons are also 2. So equal number of protons and neutrons are almost present in that nucleus. So this is the here completes that the subatomic particles, which are electrons, protons and the neutrons, and how they discovered also we studied that. In next class we shall go through that how electrons are distributed in the different shells. So we have already said that the electrons are revolving around the nucleus in the discrete energy levels. So how they are differently revolving under the differently energy shells, we shall see in the next class. And after that,